today's experiment is measurements of angles using bevel protractor. Bevel protractor is the direct measuring instruments. Any measuring instruments you are used, first you have to find out the least count. How to find out least count? There is one formula is there, that is value of one main scale reading divided by total number of vernier scale reading. Okay, now see, value of one main scale reading is 1 degree. Total number of vernier scale divisions. Now see, in this bevel protractor, here 0 to 3, 6, 9, 12. This is forward vernier. Now see, 0, 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30, 35, 40, 45, 50, 55, 60. They were mentioned totally 12 equal divisions. Okay. Now see, the value of the one main scale division is 1 degree. So, totally 12. Vernier scale division is 12 divisions. So the formula is value of one main scale divisions divided by total number of vernier scale divisions. Now see, value of one main scale division is 1 degree. Now we have to convert in degree into minutes. 60 minutes is nothing but 1 degree, no? So 60 divided by 12 equals, that is 5 minutes is the least count. In this way, we have to find out the least count. Minimum 5 minutes we can possible to measure the least value, measure the bevel protractor. Okay. Now how to measure the bevel protractor? Now see, this is the specimen. In this specimen, see here, this is acute angle. Now see here, so this is 90 degree, no? Right angle triangle. This side also right angle triangle. Totally 360 degree. Now you place this one in this one. Mark it. Okay. Now see, this is 90 degree. So this one is below the 90 degree. So this portion is called it as below 90 degree acute angle. Okay. Now you reverse that one. Okay. Now place it here. Now see here, this is 90 degree. This is above 90 degree. So this portion is obtuse angle. Acute angle, obtuse angle. Then this side, right angle triangle. This is exactly 90 degrees there. Next, one more degree is there, that is included angle or slope angle. See? Take in this way. Okay. This is acute angle, obtuse angle, right angle triangle 90 degree. One more angle is this one. This is included to the bottom to the slope. This way. Now we have to measure 3 angles. One is acute angle, obtuse angle, and included angle. Okay. Now how to measure these angles? First you make it in this way. The zero of the vernier scale is exactly coincide to 90 degree here. Okay, now place it in this way, slide it. Then lock this one, both of them. Okay, now you see the zero of the vernier is, now see here, 74th division is coinciding, almost nearer to the 75, not exactly 75, nearer to the 75. After that you see the vernier scale divisions. In this vernier scale divisions, suppose first division coincided means 5 minutes. Okay. Now see, fifth division is coinciding to the nearer main scale divisions. So 5 into 5, 25 minutes. Yes, 74 degree, 25 minutes. Okay, this is acute angle. If you measure one directions, whether acute angle or obtuse angle, automatically 180 minus that acute angle, you got obtuse angle also. But we have to measure both all the sides, because we don't know it is exactly 90 degree or not. So that's why you are measure individually. Okay, reverse that one. Suppose if it is exactly 90 degree means 180 degree minus this acute angle, what are the angle you are got, minus that one, you directly you got the exact value. But it is not exactly 90 degree, so individually you have to measure this way. Lock it. Now see, this is obtuse angle, no? The coinciding vernier is acute angle below 90 degree. You go for the coinciding vernier is backward vernier. If you want to measure obtuse angle, the coinciding vernier is, you have to concentrate forward vernier. Okay, forward vernier. Now you see the zero is ninety here. Okay, 90 plus 10, 24. 90 plus 24, how much? 114 degree. Okay, that is obtuse angle. This one. 90 is our reference. Okay, 90 plus 14 division. That is 114 degree. Now you concentrate the forward vernier, which line is exactly coincide, you see here. Now here 7th division is coinciding. 7 into 5, 35 minutes. Acute angle is how much?
114 degrees, 35 minutes.
35 minutes. Okay. The same way, see this side. Okay. This way, you have to measure the acute and obtuse angles. So, easily you have to conclude this is not exactly 90 degree, because some variation is there, no? Okay. If it is exactly 90, means you have to measure one side is enough. Now you measure the included angle. How to measure included angle? Bring this blade.
This is fixed blade, this is movable blade. Okay, do this one. Now.
Now see, you measure this way. Okay. The slope is exactly matched in this blade, movable blade. Now measure it here. Now the included angle is, the zero is cross the 25th division of the vernier scale. So 25 degree. Then this is also backward vernier, no? So you see here, this is forward and backward vernier. Fifth line is coinciding. So here also seventh line is coinciding. So 24 degree 35 minutes. Clear? This way I have to measure the acute angle, obtuse angle and included angle. If you are measure acute angle, the vernier, coinciding vernier is, you have to concentrate backward vernier. Because this is below 90 degree, so your concentration is backward vernier. Here both sides are there, forward vernier and backward vernier. If you are measure obtuse angle, your concentration is forward vernier. Acute angle, if you are measure acute angle, your concentration is backward vernier. In this you have to concentrate. Okay, that's